Listen, I don't have to take this. I have an evil plan to get back to.
Well, your plan stops here. Now hand over the stolen tech.
Don't make us take you down, dude.
Ha! I'd like to see you try. I can calculate your every move.
Oh, yeah? Then calculate this.
Calculating acceleration.
Magic fist!
Calculating velocity!
Ooh, my bad.
Ha! Too easy!
Oh yeah? Then let's see if you can dodge these heat-seeking missiles!
Calculating trajectory!
Ah, man! We can't even touch this guy!
That's because only math can defeat him!
No problem! We got this! Okay, so if he's traveling at 13 miles per hour and we're traveling at 15 miles per hour, at which point do our fists hit his face?
One, two, hold on. I'm gonna need a pen and paper.
Hook me up with some of that loose leaf too, Mama!
Come on, Titans, hurry it up!
We are going as fast as we can, Robin!
Okay, just gotta double check our work and got it!
Oh no, he got away!
Listen up, Titans. If we're going to stop the calculator, we need to become better at math than he is.
But how's we supposed to do that?
The dude is literally a calculator.
It's simple. Today, I'm going to be teaching you a new, faster method for doing mathematics, known as Common Core Math.
You are teaching us the belly math, Robin?
We don't need to learn that, fool. Because we already knows we got them good six-packs going on. Check it.
The washboard. The cheese grater! The patch-o-patch-o-patch-o-patch!
No, Titans! Common Core Math doesn't have to do with your core muscles. It's a method of learning that will help you all become better at math.
Wait a minute. I know what Robin's talking about now. He's trying to teach us that math the government made up just to confuse people.
What?
Is that the true?
Yes, it's true that Common Core Math was developed by government educators and has been given a bad reputation from parents who are confused by its methodology. But I assure you, Titans, you can handle it. After all, six-year-olds can understand Common Core Math, and to demonstrate how easy it is, we shall start with the most basic Common Core lesson, the 10-frame.
10-frame? Like in bowling?
Bowling is the best, yo!
Yeah!
This isn't about bowling! The 10-frame is simply a 2x5 rectangular grid into which circular counters are drawn to demonstrate numbers less than or equal to 10.
Man, that's some straight-up gobbledygook right there.
I, too, am confused by the gooking of the gobbledy.
So, instead of us using numbers, we're supposed to draw circles?
I thought we was doing math, not arts and crafts.
Don't get hung up on the circles. They're only there to represent number values and can be whatever shape you want them to be.
Oh, really? Then can we change them to your baby hands?
No, you cannot change them into baby hands.
But you said they could be whatever's we want.
And we choose the baby hands.
Baby hands!
Stop! Give me that!
We're just having some fun, Robin.
Common Core Math isn't supposed to be fun. It's supposed to be boring and educational. Now, let's forget about the 10 frame and move on.
But we still haven't learned nothing, yo!
That's okay, because I guarantee you'll understand this next Common Core lesson, which uses line segments as anchors.
Anchors! Like the ones the pirates use?
Ooh, Robin is teaching us pirate math.
Yeah, boy!
Arr, let's use our pirate math to divide up this treasure, me hearties.
Here you go, lads. One for you, and one for me.
Avast! The two doubloons do not equal the shimmering necklace.
Are you trying to cheat us, matey?
Nay, I would never even dream of cheating the likes of you.
Cheat you, he is.
We shall run you through for this.
Stop! This lesson doesn't involve filthy pirates. These anchors are simply used to break big numbers into smaller number bonds to simplify the problem.
Well, that problem doesn't look simplified to me.
Indeed, it looks still way more complicated.
Yeah, man, you can be adding in a bunch of numbers all willy-nilly like that.
It's super confusing, yo.